Welcome to the Office 365 update for February of 2017. As we started working on this update video, we paused to take a look back at our humble origins. This series started 3 years ago, back when I still thought it was styling to wear a pink shirt. Come to think of it, I might be overdue for a wardrobe refresh now. I'm going to have to noodle on that one a bit more. The original update series was available only to Microsoft internal employees. At their request, we began publishing the Office 365 update series on YouTube in October of 2015 to make that content available to our customers and partners. The response has been phenomenal, and according to the Power BI dashboard I whipped up, the Office 365 update series now has over 300,000 views on YouTube. I'm pleased that we've also been able to fulfill another user request. We added an RSS feed so you can subscribe to this video via your favorite podcast player or RSS reader. We're already in the iTunes podcast library, and of course there's the Windows Phone podcast player, but please let me know what podcast player you use and we'll work to set that up if there's enough demand. As always, everything you need to subscribe to the podcast or get more detail on anything we address in this video is in the additional resources. Microsoft is always making improvements to Office 365, and the goal of these videos is to demonstrate how you can leverage those improvements to help you or your organization do more. The best part of my job is hearing how this series is positively impacting your life, like this email I recently received from the IT manager of a popular restaurant chain here in the US. In this age of digital transformation, Microsoft's goal is to make life a bit easier, not only for IT managers like Sean, but for all Office users. Microsoft OneDrive Sync technology allows you to work with shared files with your team in Office 365 or SharePoint as easy as files stored on your computer, simplifying collaboration, even if you're offline. But many of you, like me, have been using two OneDrive Sync clients. The first, sometimes called the Next Generation Sync client, synced files stored in OneDrive for Business and OneDrive Personal. A second Sync client kept SharePoint Online and SharePoint on-premises files in sync. On January 24th, we announced that the day has finally arrived where the Next Generation Sync client also works with SharePoint Online. This makes things easier for admins and brings more flexibility and performance to end users. Please note that those of you running SharePoint on-premises will still need to use that second sync client I spoke of. The same article where this news was posted contains information and links on this and related OneDrive developments, so be sure to check it out. Good news! On January 12th, Microsoft announced it was adding over 60 new LinkedIn Learning courses to Microsoft's Office Training Center. The LinkedIn Learning videos can be found alongside the hundreds of courses already there. These videos help you quickly get up to speed on Office, whether you need to learn about tracking changes in Word or designing PowerPoint presentations. You can easily find training based on a specific Office solution or general topic, such as how to become more productive with Office 365. While my goal with these update videos is to keep you informed on what's new, the Office Training Center will provide step-by-step instructions on how to get the most out of each Office solution. If you're not using this training already, you'll definitely want to check it out. Microsoft recently announced the worldwide launch of Microsoft StaffHub. It's designed to help deskless workers manage their workday with schedule management, information sharing, and the ability to connect to other work-related apps and resources. StaffHub makes it easy for managers to create, update, and manage shift schedules for their team, streamlining what has traditionally been a very labor-intensive process. Employees simply view their upcoming schedules on their mobile device. The StaffHub app home screen provides a summary of upcoming shifts as well as any important notes. When schedule conflicts inevitably come up, StaffHub makes it easy to either swap a shift or offer the shift to somebody else. Requests are always routed to the manager for approval, and updates and notifications are automatically sent to the team. StaffHub also enables managers to quickly distribute information to their team, such as policy documents, news bulletins, or training videos. It's also easy for managers to send quick messages to their team members. Employees can also send messages directly to each other or to the entire work group. Microsoft StaffHub also supports the ability for admins to define custom links for workers to view in the mobile app. These links can point to important resources or sites such as HR systems for reporting time off, or to custom applications built with tools such as Microsoft Power Apps. Microsoft StaffHub is available on the web, and there are apps for iOS and Android. For all the details and to see a preview of Microsoft StaffHub in action, read the January 12th Office blog post. Research has proven that people learn and retain information that is presented to them visually, so I'm always looking for ways to add images and graphics to the content I create. Last September, I told you about Picket Presentation Images, an Office add-in that lets you download unlimited royalty-free photos and icons from Picket's curated collections. There's another stock photo app I like called Pexels that expands your stock photo options. Simply install the Pexels app and you can browse through standard definition images from Pexels' vast free library. Photos available through Pexels are licensed under the Creative Commons Zero license. This means the pictures are completely free for personal and commercial use, and attribution is not required. You can even modify the photos to suit your needs without breaking any rules. This is a good time to remind you that PowerPoint has a robust set of tools that enable you to modify and adjust images. One of my favorite is the Remove Background feature. For example, if you drop in a photo from Pexels and the background in the photo doesn't quite go with your slide design, you can easily remove it. Simply double-click on the photo to bring up the picture tools. Click on Remove Background, make a few minor adjustments, and you're all set. Pexels is a great add-in for people working in PowerPoint and Word. Be sure to check out the Office Store for other useful apps that work seamlessly with Office to enhance your productivity. Back in April 2016, Microsoft started rolling out a new Office 365 homepage experience that provided a redesigned environment for users to collaborate and work across any device. To ring in the new year, the Office team began rolling out changes that make it even easier to navigate apps and find the documents you've worked on most recently. They started rolling out in late December and will continue through early 2017. When you access your Office 365 homepage, you'll see additional controls within the Recent Documents list that enable you to filter by document type across Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and OneNote. If you have documents that you go back to frequently, you can pin them to the list, and they're always just a click away. The Office.com homepage also has a new calendar section so you can see upcoming events at a glance. There's also an in-depth view of the day's meetings, and you can join Skype for business calls with just one click. Again, these changes started rolling out in late December and will continue through early 2017. Keep your eye out for them on office.com. Data loss prevention is an important capability that ensures that the organization's sensitive data doesn't get into the wrong hands. The Office team has announced a new unified management experience for data loss prevention, policy creation, and reporting that spans Exchange Online, SharePoint Online, and OneDrive for Business. Up to now, IT admins have managed data loss prevention for Exchange Online via the Exchange Admin Center, while managing SharePoint Online and OneDrive for Business data loss prevention from the Office 365 Security and Compliance Center. With the new unified approach, admins can create a single data loss prevention policy in the Office 365 Security and Compliance Center that covers all three, reducing the time and effort required to set up and maintain security and compliance. Along with unified policy creation, we also now provide a single location to view reports for your data loss prevention policies across Exchange Online, SharePoint Online, and OneDrive for Business. This makes it easier to understand the business impact of your data loss prevention policies and uncover actions that violate policies across multiple workloads. There are additional details in the January 9th Office blog post, along with additional information on data loss prevention events in the Activity Management API. That's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again next month.